Hello friends and welcome back to my channel. As an educator, are you looking for ways to integrate generative AI tools into your teaching? Do you want to ensure that you can equip your students to use generative AI critically, responsibly, and ethically, not only in their current studies, but also in their future careers? Well, today I'm going to show you how you can do this by using a really clear framework called PAIR that I came across, created by Professor Acar. I've added some links to his materials below. What I really like about the PAIR framework is that it encourages the use of AI as a learning collaborator. And I think that this is useful because it can help educators demonstrate to students how AI tools can help them with tasks such as research, communication, creativity, and reflection. The PAIR framework also enables students to recognize that their use of AI tools can also pose ethical challenges and risks, such as problems with accuracy, bias, plagiarism, and privacy concerns. So, if you're interested in teaching your students how to use AI tools critically and ethically, keep watching as I provide an overview and hands-on example of how you too can apply the PAIR framework in your teaching. At the end of the video, let me know how you could use lessons from this video in your own teaching by leaving a comment in the comment section below. I'd really love to hear from you. Before demonstrating how I would use the PAIR framework, let me provide a brief overview of the five essential skills that it seeks to develop in students so that they are able to use AI tools responsibly. These skills are 1. Problem formulation. This is the ability for students to develop skills in identifying, analysing, and defining problems to explore. 2. Is exploration. With new AI tools coming onto the market all the time, PAIR is really good in encouraging students to develop skills in critically exploring and becoming familiar with resources such as ChatGPT, Google Bard, and others. 3 is experimentation. PAIR provides opportunities for students to develop skills in the use of these tools. 4 is critical thinking. AI tools can produce biased and inaccurate results, so opportunities to develop skills in critically looking at the outputs is important, as well as allowing space to deepen students' learning. And finally, 5, reflection. Professor Acar argues that sometimes engaging with AI systems can evoke strong emotions, particularly when exploring topics closely linked to our identity or self-worth. In these situations, reflective practice skills can help students understand and deal with their potential emotional reactions to the AI-generated content. So what do we need to do to develop these skills? Well, the PAIR framework consists of 4 steps. These are problem, AI tool selection, interaction, and reflection. So in the first one, what you do is you help your student to define a problem or challenge they want to address with the help of AI tools. In the second step, you'd encourage your students to explore, identify, and choose the most suitable generative AI tools to help them address the problem or challenge that they've formulated. In the third step, what you would do is you would create spaces for students to use the selected tools to tackle the problem, allowing them to experiment with diverse inputs and helping them to critically evaluate the outputs. And in the final reflection stage, we'd encourage students to reflect, assess, and report on their experiences of using the AI tools. And what I really like about this framework is that it can be tailored to different levels of complexity and inquiry, depending on the learning objectives and the characteristics of your students. Also, it's helpful that it's designed in such a way that it complements and enhances your existing coursework or learning designs. It doesn't seek to replace them, so with a little bit of creativity, you should find it easy to integrate PAIR into your existing lesson plans. So do let me know how you get on in terms of using it. In this section of the video, I'm going to illustrate how the PAIR framework can be implemented in practice. So in this example learning design, I'm going to use a 1-hour teaching session with final year undergraduate students to create a coursework assignment for a social work module that involves writing an essay on the impact of AI on social justice. In class, to begin with, I would create small learning groups of 5 to 6 students. My own research has shown that the conversations that take place in small groups really helps with the processes of inquiry, critical thinking, and learning. So let's go to the pair framework. In the problem section part of the framework, I'd set the small groups the tasks of working on the assignment. I'd provide the students with the broad theme of AI and social justice, and ask them to choose a specific area within this theme, such as AI and human rights, or AI and discrimination. So in the second step, AI, once the group have completed the first step, I'd ask them to use the second part of the pair framework and ask them to formulate a clear research question and a thesis statement for their essay. To do this, I'd provide them with a list of generative AI tools that could help them with this and various other tasks related to their essay preparation and writing process, which would normally involve generating ideas about the assignment question, creating an outline, conducting research, or receiving feedback. I'd really encourage the students to work together to make notes on the AI tools they've explored, chosen, or discarded, along with brief justifications for their choices. So let's assume that they've chosen to use ChatGPT, as it is one of the most popular generative AI tools for text generation. This is where the fun really begins. This is the interaction stage, and this is where the students would then use ChatGPT to generate some ideas for their research question. So let's look at what they might do. I'm going to pull up ChatGPT here. So they may type into ChatGPT something along the lines of the following prompt: create some research questions about AI and human rights. Please relate to keywords, challenges, opportunities, social work ethics. You'll see that ChatGPT then generates several possible research questions based on the prompt, such as, what are the key challenges in implementing AI technologies to protect and uphold human rights? And how can they be mitigated in the context of social work ethics? Also, what opportunities does AI present for improving the monitoring and enforcement of human rights, especially in marginalised communities? And how can these opportunities be harnessed responsibly? It goes on to also propose, how do AI-driven algorithms affect decision-making in the field of social work? And what ethical considerations should be taken into account to ensure that human rights are upheld in this process? And you can see that ChatGPT has also generated a number of other suggestions. What's interesting is you can see that ChatGPT is able to generate some relevant and interesting research questions that the group could then discuss before deciding on one to base their assignment on. However, you know, if they're encouraged to reflect on the outputs, they should see that if they are critical, there are some questions that are too broad, vague, or even repetitive. So my suggestion is that I would encourage the students to think about if they want to refine and narrow the questions to make them more specific and focused by, for example, experimenting with different prompts and inputs and evaluating the quality, relevance, accuracy, and bias of the outputs. While they're undertaking this task, I'd want them to collectively keep a record of and discuss amongst themselves their interactions with ChatGPT, noting the inputs provided, their iterations, and the outputs that they eventually receive. I'd also encourage them to cite the specific AI tools and the versions they've used for each output. The aim here is to encourage the students to experience how using tools like ChatGPT can impact on their problem-solving processes and outcomes. So here's another example of how a student group could continue the interaction in this stage of the pair framework to use ChatGPT to generate an outline for their essay. To do this, the students, after discussion, could give ChatGPT a prompt that includes their research question. Let's imagine that they've not adapted this and decided just to go with it as it is. So they type in, what are the challenges in implementing AI technologies to protect and uphold human rights? And how can they be mitigated in the context of social work ethics? They could also add, and ask it to base the outline on an introduction, literature review, analysis, and conclusion. You'll see then that ChatGPT then generates a possible outline for their essay, based on the prompt, It advises that the students could, in their introduction, provide a brief overview of the importance of human rights in the field of social work, introduce the significance of AI technologies in addressing human rights issues, state the research question and purpose of the assignment, and present a preview of the structure of the assignment. I quite like the way that it's actually structured, this introduction. Then it goes on to the literature review, and here what it asks is that the student should define and explain the concept of AI technologies in the context of social work, discuss the role of AI in protecting and upholding human rights, review existing literature on the challenges associated with implementing AI in social work ethics, explore case studies and real-world examples of AI applications in social work, and examine the ethical considerations surrounding AI in the field of social work. I won't read through the rest, but you can pause the video and scroll through the rest of the output. At the end, ChatGPT says, feel free to expand on each section with more details, examples, and references as needed for your assignment. If you need specific context for any part of the assignment, please let me know and I can provide further assistance. Now, some of the students in their groups may wish to take up this offer. During this stage, what I will be doing is going around each group and posing questions to them that make them critically and carefully look at the outputs. And my questions could include ones such as, are the sections produced here by ChatGPT too generic, incomplete, or inconsistent? Should you modify and expand some sections to make them more specific and relevant to the topic that you're exploring? How can you check the accuracy, relevance, and potential bias or originality of the outputs that you're starting to generate? And you can see that although ChatGPT was able to generate a coherent and logical outline for an essay, the students should still be encouraged to critically reflect on the outputs before using them in their chosen assignments. In the final step of the framework, I'd ask the students to write individual reflective reports in which they analyse their experiences of using ChatGPT and how it may impact on their essay writing process. I'd also want them to reflect on the broader implications of using AI tools for their discipline and society. To do this, I'd ask them to answer questions such as, what challenges did you encounter when using the AI tools and how did you overcome them? In what ways did the AI tools enhance or hinder your problem-solving processes? How did using the AI tools affect your understanding of your topic and your arguments? What surprised you most about your interactions with the AI tools? What emotions did you experience while interacting with the AI tools? What ethical issues or dilemmas did you face when using the AI tools? How do you think using the AI tools will affect your future academic or professional work? I hope you can see that implementing the PAIR framework is not that difficult. With a little bit of preparation and experimentation, you too can teach your students how to harness the power of generative AI tools in their studies, while also critically helping them develop key skills and awareness for using them responsibly. A point to be aware of is that if your students do use AI outputs in their assignments, you must make clear in your module assessment guidance what is and is not acceptable AI practice. By providing this level of clarity, you can avoid problems of academic integrity arising. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video and do let me know how you could use PAIR in your own work by leaving a comment in the comment section below. I'd really enjoy hearing from you. If you want to learn more about generative AI tools for education, please check out this link. Thank you for watching and don't forget to like, share and subscribe for more videos on AI in education. I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye.